Welcome. In this video, we are going to examine the technical requirements of Drupal and be introduced to local development environment options, which both fulfill those Drupal requirements and at the same time provide a modern development environment. Let's go. Drupal is a sophisticated software framework which leverages modern software engineering design principles and many third-party vendor libraries. The system requirements needed to run Drupal are standard in many modern web frameworks. These standards are collectively known as the stack, which consists of a database server, a web server, a modern PHP version, and importantly, the package management tool for PHP called Composer. Let's get an overview of each of these. Drupal Core is compatible with MySQL, MariaDB, Percona Server, PostgreSQL, and SQLite. There are pros and cons to each database server, and each also has its own minimum version requirements. I advise you to view the database server requirements on drupal.org as these requirements do change. A link is provided. The recommended database servers are MySQL, MariaDB, or Percona Server. Drupal will run on any web server with a version of PHP that meets Drupal's minimum PHP version. At the time of this recording, at least PHP 7.3 is required for Drupal Core 9.1. Usually, Nginx or Apache is chosen as the web server. Drupal Core also works with Microsoft IIS if PHP is configured correctly. There are detailed technical specifications specific to each web server. You will find the web server requirements directly on drupal.org. When using Drupal, you need to be running a stable and modern version of PHP. With Drupal 9, PHP version 7.3 or higher is needed. Drupal 9.1.0 and above is compatible with newly released PHP version 8. In addition to the minimum PHP version, Drupal also requires numerous PHP extensions to be enabled. A few of these are PHP Data Object Extension, XML Extension, and Image Library, and other extensions are required. You can view the official required PHP extensions on drupal.org. Phew! As you can tell, managing all these specific Drupal system requirements can quickly become daunting and cumbersome in your local development environment. This is why we will cover elegant solutions to fulfilling these requirements in this video in a bit. Composer is the concluding system requirement of Drupal to mention here. At this time, it is not an official Drupal.org requirement, but I am going to suggest, based upon the direction of modern web development and Drupal, that you consider Composer as a requirement and adapt it into your workflow as such. Composer is a tool for dependency management in PHP. It allows you to declare the modules, themes, and third-party library your Drupal project depends on, and like magic, then Composer installs and updates, that is, manages those dependencies for you. In an upcoming video, we will learn more about Composer and how to install Drupal using Composer. Now that we have reviewed the main components of Drupal's system technical requirements, and we have a better understanding of the type of software we need to install locally to run Drupal locally, the solutions recommended here are modern and elegant environments specific to working with Drupal. I encourage you to try out these straightforward-to-use environments and choose one that works for you. These tools are Lando, DDev, and Acquia Cloud IDE. Lando and DDev are installed locally on your machine and are available free to anyone. Acquia Cloud IDE is an elegant browser-based solution which requires no installation, but it is only available to eligible Acquia customers. Since every local environment is unique and has different security policies, I simply cannot know which local environment solution will or will not work for you. So, If you or your organization already have an existing environment and it can sufficiently fulfill the system requirements of modern Drupal, then feel free to use your local environment. For this course, I am using DDev as my local environment. Lando works in a similar manner and is just as robust. Recent improvements by Acquia indicate that Lando may be a better choice if you are hosting your site on Acquia. Both Lando and DDev are based on Docker, and I'll briefly give an overview as to why a Docker-based development environment is beneficial. Of course, you should do your own research as to which solution you prefer and which are compatible with your situation. So what is special about Docker? Docker adds an application deployment engine on top of a virtualized container execution environment. It is designed to provide a lightweight and fast environment in which to run your code, as well as an efficient workflow to get that code from your computer to your test environment and then into production. Docker is incredibly straightforward. Docker is great for local development environments because of the small footprint and fast startup times. While a virtual machine, or a VM, can take at least a few minutes to boot and be development ready, it takes anywhere from a few milliseconds to at most a few seconds to start a Docker container from a container image. Containers can be shared across multiple team members, bringing much-needed portability across the development pipeline. This reduces those, "hey, it works on my machine" errors that plague the DevOps team. Note that this is not a comprehensive guide to Docker. This is merely an introduction for learning and discovery purposes. Docker is a tool that can package software into containers that run reliably in any environment. But what is a container, and why do you need one? Let's imagine you are building a Drupal 9 website that runs on a specific version of PHP and a specifically configured web server and database server. It should go without much explaining that there is a benefit to your local environment exactly matching the production environment of the Drupal site. Okay, so you've set up your local environment exactly as you need. Now, you want to share your Drupal 9 site with your friend, but she has an entirely different system. So the problem becomes, how do we replicate the current Drupal environment on our machine? How do we share that with other people? One way is to package the Drupal site and its system requirements with a virtual machine. Speaking basically, a virtual machine is where the hardware is simulated with its own operating system. Virtual machines do allow us to run multiple apps on the same infrastructure. However, because each VM is running its own operating system, hardware virtualizations tend to be bulky and slow. Now, a Docker container is conceptually very similar to a VM with one key difference. Instead of virtualizing hardware, containers only virtualize the operating system. In other words, all apps for Docker containers are run by a single kernel, that is, your existing operating system kernel. And this makes almost everything faster and more efficient. All of this makes it straightforward to match your local development environment to the testing and production environments where your Drupal site will live. Docker also makes it easy for others in your team to also host this exact environment. To summarize, there are three primary benefits of using Docker. The kernel of the host's operating system is shared across all the containers. Each container is isolated from other existing containers. And Docker virtualizes the operating system of the host, not the hardware. Lando and DDev are like a recipe solution to assemble Drupal projects using Docker. Tools such as Lando and DDev leverage Docker to create images which are built to the system requirements of Drupal and contain all the necessary database servers, web servers, PHP versions, and Composer. So this brings us to the end of the video. To complete this video also means an action item for you. Before continuing on in the course, you need to make sure that your local development environment is suitable to host a recent version of Drupal. Choose and install an environment that works for you. Enjoy the process and happy learning. Oh.
you.